What is up, guys? All my gorks. All my dorks, geeks, nerds, and gamers, welcome to the show. I'm your host, Ghost, back with Nikey. Check out his channel, link in the description. Today we are talking about the future of next-gen consoles. This series is going to be titled, We Got Issues, and it's about issues that are true to the gaming world. Not just gaming, but the entertainment industry as a whole. Because there are issues, and we're going to talk about them in these videos. But this issue is not as pressing as some of the others. This is kind of a more lax issue for episode one. And that is the future of next-gen consoles. We know for a fact that PS5 will be coming end of this year. I think it'll be announced this year.
Yeah, at the Expo.
Yeah, it'll be announced this year and released next year. We know that that's going to be a powerful console. We know it's going to be running Unreal Engine 5 or whatever they're working on. We know it's going to have good internet capabilities. It's going to be... We don't know if it's going to use disc yet. We don't know if it's going to be digital only. But I assume with Sony, they're going to have a disc-based backwards compatibility system. With PS4, I would assume, because that's their biggest. That was their biggest console since PS2, because PS3 really didn't sell, so that's why they didn't make that backwards compatible. So I could see them doing something like that. What are your thoughts on this on the PS5?
I think it's just everything they did well with PS4. They're just gonna tune it up, and they're going to dial it up probably about like 5.
That's what I think. I think it's going to run well. It's going to be good. And I love my PS4. I use it every single day of my life. Like, almost every second of every day it's on. But yeah, that's Sony. I'm going to get that one. I'm definitely buying that one. On Nintendo's end, we have the Switch that came out, and I don't think they're going to abandon that. I think they're really going to still push the Switch. Switch is their... Next is their biggest thing at the moment. I think they're going to continue that trend. We might get a new console announcement in 3, maybe 4 years with Nintendo, but I wouldn't expect anything soon. On the other end, we have Microsoft, who is planning on releasing 2 consoles. One that is streaming only, and it looks like it'll be wireless in the future. But they're also, like they have their Xbox and their Xbox One S, they're also trying to do that system where they're probably going to have a wired version and a wireless version or something like that, because they're working on 2 different products at the moment for the Xbox. We don't know what they are. We know they'll have streaming capabilities and all that stuff. But if you don't have good games in your system, who gives a crap if you can stream crappy games, you know what I'm saying? So they need to work on their first-party games, like their Halos and their Gears. And if they come up with some, they need new IPs. They haven't had a new IP since the Xbox 360. That works. I mean, Sunset Overdrive was their most recent one. But they need to work on that, I think. Anything you want to add with Xbox?
No, nothing.
Nothing. I'm probably going to pass on Xbox until I see how it runs and see what exclusives they get. If they do get good exclusives, I'll pick it up. If not, it's not for me, guys. I'm not an Xbox guy. Sorry. And then last but not least, we have this Madbox coming out from the developers of, I think, Project Cars. And this is going to be, it's a PC for the most part, but it's a console as well. So it almost reminds me of the Steam Box in a way that they tried to push out, that was kind of like a game console PC sort of thing. It could work. I don't know. They have no exclusives?
No, they said they weren't going to focus on exclusives yet.
So I don't understand why release a console for third-party games. But they're doing it?
I mean, we actually haven't had a different... We haven't had an actual different...
system from the main three.
To really battle against Sony and Microsoft and Nintendo.
Except for back in the 90s, it was Sega who was there, and they had their Genesis and their Dreamcast. And I think the Dreamcast, or was it the Dreamcast with their last system?
yeah.
on the market. And then they pulled out because Nintendo was just destroying them so hard. But yeah, I mean, we'll give it a shot. We'll see how it does in the market, see what they can do with it, what kind of unique options they have for that system. But yeah, guys, that's going to be, and then we also, our phones, our mobile phones look like they're going to be more and more marketed towards gamers because, you know, you look at Diablo and...
Yeah, Diablo launching, then they put the PUBG on
PUBG,
there.
Yeah, and all this stuff. I think, so yeah, I mean, next-gen future consoles is looking pretty good. We have a good future to look forward to. We don't know much right now. But the more we know, we'll contact, you know, we'll make another video updating it of what's going on and when it's going to happen.
I think the big thing, I think all of them are going to push, is they're really going to try to dive into the world of streaming and recording.
Yeah.
Like, for me, in my instance, I do all mine on my PS4.
Yeah.
I do have me a really good top-level PC, but I still don't have all the components to stream. I mean, I can record videos, but streaming, I mean, it's a whole different.
Right.
Yet there's so much stuff. So I think that's what they're going to push.
I think so too. I think that's what's going to be, streaming is going to be the big thing. But I don't think disc-based games are going to be gone, because there's still a huge market for that. And if Microsoft does that, that could be their undoing, just like the Xbox One.
Well, I think they're already at a disadvantage trying to work on two different consoles. Like I said, you want to make the other one wireless, which... No, I mean, that's amazing.
That's a good idea. That's a good concept, but, yes. Yeah, but if you have nothing to play...
You can't. It feels like me for that, they're trying to target like the high-level gamers.
Yeah.
Main gamers.
Yeah.
People who put their money and stuff into it.
Right.
Because if you don't have a good connection and all that, it's going to break. And it's just, it won't run well.
Exactly. I agree 100%.
Like I said, with your other, like, you know, your Xbox and your PS4 and all that, you can run them wireless. Wireless, which is fine, if you have a strong internet connection.
Right.
If you don't, then hardwire makes it way easier.
Yeah. And another thing about this Madbox is, another thing that could contribute to its success is the controllers. What kind of controller is it going to use? Is it going to be able to use PlayStation 4 controllers? Is it able to use Xbox One controllers? You know what I'm saying? So, depending on the integratability with that, I think the success will also hinge on that.
It's a good thing.
Because if they release a crappy, cheap controller, nobody's going to buy that box.
Yeah, I wonder if Sony's going to elaborate on their PS4 controller now.
I'm sure they will in some form. They always, I mean, they have. Like,
they introduced the touchpad, which... Yeah.
I enjoy it for, like, open world games, like to use the map and stuff. I love my touchpad, because you just click it, there's your map. That's a perfect use for a touchpad.
But to me, like, the biggest thing that, when the PS4 first came out, and they... brought out Killzone, Shadowfall. That was like really the only game where it was like trying to utilize your touchpad to see what you can do with it.
Yep. And I'm sure we'll get some of that towards launch with those games innovating, but then it'll slowly, like always, it'll fall to the wayside. But that's my thoughts on it, guys. You have anything you want to say?
Pretty much it.
It's been your host, Ghost. Make sure to like, subscribe, share, hit that bell.
Do all the cool things with whatever you can do.
Make sure to check out his channel in the description below, guys. Till next time.